Hey guys, so in this video, I wanted to address this topic of which version of the Bible, English Bible translation, is the best. Because it comes up, and even especially in Christian circles, of course it comes up. And this usually is an either-or choice for most people. King James Version or any other version. That's really the ultimate debate when it gets down to it. When we get there, you know, you can have all kinds of debates about the versions of the English translations, but ultimately that's what it gets down to. Are you going to accept the King James Version as the best version, the most, you know, godly version, the most pious version of the Bible, or not? Or is it just that, you know, all the other translations are okay, are just as Christian? And that's usually what the debate revolves down to. And I think I've also I got a couple comments on my Bible reading videos where it's just like, oh man, you're reading from the corrupt New International Version, or you're doing the English Standard Version. You know, the only true version is the King James Version, and that's why you're so misguided. Surprisingly, I don't get this comment on the videos where I've read from the King James Version. So that's interesting that, you know, I'm reading some of the videos, I'm reading the King James Version. I still make the argument this is a lot of the stuff that appears on King James Version is horrific. And dumb. Such stupidity, such immorality, such brutality is still there, even if I'm reading the King James Version. And so that's why I like to read all versions. But ultimately, it does get down. This question does come up, and I do feel like I should address it because I'm reading so many versions of the Bible throughout my Bible reading experience. You know, I started with the New International Version. On some important chapters, I did read again in King James Version, like Genesis chapter 1, because it's Genesis chapter 1. Come on. So, yeah, I have, and there are notable differences between King James Version and the other versions. To be fair, sometimes King James Version chapters are identical or nearly identical to New International Version. But, you know, something like the English Standard Version will have very different meanings in some of the verses. That happens, you know? So, it's not like it's King James Version versus all others. Sometimes that's not necessarily the case. Sometimes a version stands out as having a very different translation. And so, I've been watching a couple of YouTube videos and reading a couple of things that argue why King James Version matters so much, why is the one version that you really need to stick to, and all the other versions are corrupt. Their arguments are convincing in some ways, but for the argument to me, because I'm not a Christian, so right off the bat, that kind of puts me off that they would make those kind of arguments. Those arguments are not meant for me. I guess those videos, those articles, are really meant for people who are already Christians and are trying to decide which Bible is right for me. I think for those people, that King James Version is the best version to go to is quite convincing. You know, the nature of divinity of Jesus and why are some verses left out in the New International Version as opposed to King James Version? Because King James Version is translated off like the correct original Greek and Hebrew text, whatever, and some things like that. And that's usually how the argument goes. And then, you know, there's so many versions of the original Greek and Hebrew texts. And so these scholars in the 16th century or 15th century, whatever, these amazing biblical scholars got together and they got it right. You know, they went through this, they spent their entire life coming up with this correct translation, and that's why King James Version is the way to go. I want to go back to the point about how there are so many Greek and Hebrew translations, versions anyway. The original version, the original Bible is not English. So, King James Version, however perfect it is, it's a translation. And I've made this point in another video somewhere, but a translation is a translation. It's not the original text. It's why in the Muslim world, in the faith of Islam, the original Arabic text of the Quran is the only text of the Quran that is considered holy and correct. Everything else, however perfectly translated, the English Quran, the Korean Quran, if that exists, the Spanish Quran, is not perfect in the Islam world. On the faith of Islam, the only perfect text, a sacred text, is the Arabic text of the Quran. And I think that argument makes sense. If the original text is considered holy, then of course it would only be holy in its original language. That makes sense to me. Whereas with the Bible, people are claiming that the King James Version is the most holy, the most uncorrupt version there is. That makes no sense considering the original text of the Bible, the original scrolls, thousands of years ago, was not English. English is just a translation of that original text. You can get the translation perfect, but it's unlikely that your translation is perfect. Even more so for the Bible, considering that the languages used in the Bible are thousands of years old. Language evolves. Like, for example, I'm Korean. You know, I know Korean. I'm fairly fluent in Korean. But the Korean I know now has evolved from the Korean that existed thousands of years ago. People in Goryeo Dynasty, thousands of years ago, do not use the same Korean that I use when I speak to my parents. Korean language has evolved. English has evolved. Greek has evolved. Hebrew has evolved. The Hebrew language that, you know, that Jewish people speak now, if they do, or the Greek language that Greek people speak now, is not the same as the Greek and Hebrew that was used thousands of years ago. And that's the language that the Bible used, the Greek and Hebrew and Aramaic, which doesn't even exist anymore, thousands of years ago. Language has changed so much. So there are words in Greek language now that never existed before, or vice versa, things like that. So to say that an English translation of the Bible, even if it's King James, is the holiest version, is crap. That makes no sense. How can it be? So many things gets lost in translation. But okay, let's say it's the perfect translation of the Bible, however that happens. How did those scholars determine which Greek or Hebrew or Arabic version of which books of the Bible were the correct books to translate from? It's so arbitrary. Like, that's why, you know, the New International Version, I know, uses a different set of original manuscripts, original Greek manuscripts. The New Testament is, especially the New Testament, there are stark differences between King James Version and New International Version. But, you know, there are also differences in Old Testament as well, such as the prophetic books like Micah and Jeremiah and Isaiah. There's differences in some chapters of Genesis, Exodus, the first five books in general are remarkably different because the Hebrew texts, there are different versions of it, different copies of it, and not all copies are the same. So I know some people argue that, some Christian apologists argue that, like, Bible is a text that's lasted for thousands of years, but its exact words and meanings have not been lost throughout its time. Sure, that's what you like to believe, but it's actually not true. Bible has, you know, if you ask any biblical scholar that's done the research and that's done the archaeology and the anthropology of the Bible, it's not true that the Bible has remained the same throughout generations. It's been revised and it's been rewritten, and there are many different copies. And in some books and some verses, no one knows which is the originally intended verse. In some verses, it seems more correct to Christians because they're like, oh, this verse actually says, you know, it speaks more highly of God. It gives more divinity to Jesus Christ, rather than, you know, I think there was a video that I saw about somebody who's arguing that King James Version is better because it's the more holy version, because in the New International Version of this verse, it says that Jesus came from an era, whereas the King James Version says Jesus came from eternity. So there is that godlihood nature ascribed in the King James Version that is missing in these other translations. So their version is the more holy, more correct one. That is not an argument for authenticity, you know? Authenticity speaks to what is original, what is actually real. You can't determine what is real by what you like. You know, like, let's say that the Battlestar Galactica. We know for a fact that the Battlestar Galactica that was created in the 1970s is the original. I actually like the more modern version. You know, the one that was made in 2000. You know, the more modern version that had four seasons, as opposed to the original 1970s one. But that's the original. I like the modern one. But just because I like the more modern one doesn't make the modern one original, the more authentic one. You know, the original is the 1970s version, even though I like it less. So to say that the King James Version is the more uncorrupt, more holy, more correct one because I like it more, it's a stupid arbitration. And it's an arbitration. That's what it is. So my point, you know, I'm not a Christian. So of course, Christians have to decide, you know, which Bible is more holy or whether it matters. You know, as long as the meaning, they get the intended spiritual meaning out of it, does it actually matter? That's one position. But another position is King James Version is the way to go if you want the most uncorrupt, most unholy version, whatever. I feel like in the Christian world, those are like the two options that they debate on about. As an atheist, I have a third option. All of them are crap. There's no way to determine which one is really authentic, which one is holy. They're all corrupt. They're all corrupt because they're all written by men, and they're all translated by human beings. They're all human inventions. They're not divinely inspired, they're not words of God. They're words of human beings that's been rewritten, revised, recollected, scattered throughout thousands of years, and then recollected again, and then revised again, and rewritten for their own agendas, and retranslated for their own agendas. That's why there's so many versions, so many copies that are kind of different. Christians like to argue that there's these set of texts that are so similar to each other, but then that's also ignoring these other sets of texts that are so different in the original Greek and Hebrew and Aramaic. So that's cherry picking which versions is authentic and which is not. When you have to consider all the copies. And when you consider all the copies, they're not all the same. So that speaks to human error and human agenda, which exists. And that also exists with English translation. Of course, the English translation is not the original language of the Bible. It never was, not in any of the books. English is a pretty modern language compared to language of Aramaic and Hebrew and Greek. They're older languages. English existed older too, but you know, English thousands of years ago is not the same as English now. You know, old British English reads so much differently than the modern English, and it's also different from region to region. You know, the English that a Texan speaks in Texas compared to an English that someone in Florida or someone in the United Kingdom or someone in Australia speaks, or an English that someone speaks in Singapore, is different English, however similar it sounds. Dialects matter. And in translations, it matters. Language evolves. Language is different from region to region, from time period to time period. So there is no way, no possible way, there just isn't, to get a perfect, holy translation out of a language that is completely different from another time. That's just being way too idealistic and wishful thinking. It's like a miracle if it actually happens that King James Version is the authentic holy version of the original text of the Bible. That's why people have faith in religion. You know, I guess that's what they have faith in, that King James Version is that holy version. But it's that faith, it has no basis in reality or any evidence supported of science of language and science of history. It just makes no sense whatsoever. And that's also to put faith in the people who composed the King James Version. Why do you trust the people of that era, the biblical scholars of that era, more than the scholars now? Well, I know why, because you think, you know, that it was a less corrupt time back. I actually heard that argument in one of the videos, that it was a less corrupt time in the 15th century than the time now of internet porn and gun violence and whatnot, which, if you think about it, is a pretty stupid argument. Really, is that's the argument, that it's a less corrupt time back then? Slavery was legal back then. Like, as a legal institution, slavery still exists now in the form of human trafficking and secretly done, and all countries practice it. Sure. You know, there's immorality in this. There's corruption and immorality, however you define that, you know, in this era. You know, if you consider marijuana smoking as immoral, sure. You know, but to say that we live in a moral time now, but the people who the biblical scholars of the King James time era were less corrupt and less immoral is relativistic folly. Like, that makes no sense, because there were certain things that were, you know, they were not perfect people. So what gives them more arbitrary judgment to consider which to translate the Bible more correctly? We can't, and there's no way to know either. We don't know their standards as well as now, where record keeping and documentation is more rigorous and thorough now, or at least we understand it better now. How people came up with English Standard Version or the American Standard Version or even the New King James Version, we understand better now how they did that than how the King James Version came up with. I mean, you could argue, but you would have to go through mountains and mountains of historical text which relies on those historical sources instead of people that are actually living now. This isn't to say that the newer versions are more reliable than the older King James Version or the New International Version. That is not my point. My point is simply that all of them, in some way, are unreliable to being this holy, incorruptible, inerrant text. They're not. They're all translations. The best possible way to read the Bible is if you know the languages of Greek, Aramaic, and Hebrew. That's always been my position, and that'll remain my position. But of course, it still complicates things, because there isn't a single Greek, Hebrew, Aramaic version of the Bible. There are multiple versions. So which is true? Which is holy? Which is sacred? That's another debate in a nutshell. Which version of the Bible is best? I don't know, but I would argue that, you know, the original language of the Bible is probably the best, not English version. Not any of the English version is the one you want to get to. But considering the fact that most of us who watch this video, most of us who I communicate to most Christians, they don't know that language. It's not like most Muslims. I think Muslims have Christians beat in this respect. You know, they argue strongly that the best and really the only holy way to read the Quran is Arabic. You know, you have to know Arabic to read the Quran properly. That's always been the argument. And the Quran is one language, Arabic. Whereas the Bible is like three different languages, three different time periods. So it's harder, and it's more, and there's also, I think the Quran is also, you know, there's one, it hasn't, it's truer to the claim that it hasn't, you know, it's the same text that it's always been. It's kind of true to Quran's credit. So you can read the Quran in its original text, Arabic, if you're fluent in Arabic. And so, you know, that's one thing. For the Bible, it's not true. You can be fluent in Greek, Hebrew, and Aramaic. You're still not probably get the correct or the original version of the Bible, because there's so many versions of it. Which version do you get? Like, which version is the best? I don't know. Who knows? I don't think anyone knows. I mean, people like to argue, like, and does it really matter to the minute, fine details? I mean, I feel like that's the position that we come down to in the end. You know, okay, so this Bible verse is missing in this version and not in this version. And this Bible verse says that Jesus did such and such, you know. But if that's missing, does it really change the entire meaning? I mean, some meanings are added, some meanings are missing. But the overall message of the Bible is still there. And that this is kind of where, you know, Muslims, I think, are wrong. You know, if you argue with, like, truly devout Muslims, if you ever do, and you don't know Arabic, you are screwed. Because they will probably say, you know, you can have all these amazing arguments, like, about how Quran says this, and it's really confusing, or it's really stupid, or it's wrong, or whatever. A Muslim will say this to you. Will say, well, have you read the Arabic Quran? And, you know, if you don't know Arabic, your answer is going to be, no, I don't know Arabic. And then the Muslim response is simply, well, then you haven't read the Quran. Because you haven't read the Arabic Quran. So any point you're making against the Quran is irrelevant because you haven't read the original version. To me, I think that's folly too. Because, okay, a lot gets lost in translation. Sure. Sure. But that doesn't mean everything gets lost in translation. You know? You can still understand a lot. A lot is carried over in translation. A lot gets lost. A lot can't be ever conveyed because, you know, language... Because language is different also means the culture is different. It's the culture that developed the language. For example, English has the word love. Korean has, let's say heart. Love and heart, right? Love is a verb. It's one word. If you go to Korean, there's four words you can use in the Korean language that means love and heart. But for different contexts. Whereas English only has one. So if I use one context, just by using the word love, I'm losing so much in that translation, so much conveyance, so much meaning. You can translate it however you want in English, you're not going to get that context, because that gets lost in translation. But at the same time, you still get love translated. Love is still there. That meaning is still there. Not everything gets lost in translation. So if you... That's a weird argument, like, you haven't read the Quran if you haven't read the Arabic Quran. Maybe, you know, some part of the Arabic Quran I did not get because I read the English Quran. But that doesn't mean I lost everything about the Quran, you know? I feel like some of the arguments you can make out of the Quran are still good points, even though it's not based in the original Quran, you know? And that's kind of the same argument I would like to make, you know, in regards to the Bible. Yes, if you believe that the King James Version is the perfect version of the Bible, and I'm wrong to make any argument, and my arguments are irrelevant because I'm basing them off of the New International Version or American Standard or a New Living Tree or any other version because it's not the King James Version, that's stupid too, because, you know what? Maybe some parts are different. Some meanings are different. But overall, the message of the Bible doesn't just dramatically change because I'm reading a different version. It's still a translation of the Greek and Hebrew and Aramaic text. On some parts, on some verses, I admit, you know, King James Version is remarkably different to the other versions. And those are, you know, if I recognize it, you know, I'm not a biblical scholar, so there are some parts that I just flip over without recognizing that. But if I recognize that, whoa, there's a huge difference here and I need to go back, then I'll probably reread the King James Version and point that out, how different it is and what that might signify. But that doesn't mean, it's still not convincing. None of the King James Version texts that I've read is convincing as to the nature of the truth of Christianity. God is still an asshole in the King James Version. And it's still scientifically illogical, the King James Version. It's still morally reprehensible. And then also puzzling and nonsensical, the King James Version. Those four criticisms that I have, four that I can name right now at the top of my head, there are more. There are those four right now. You know, scientific stupidity, just nonsensical, morally reprehensible, all those things, they still apply to the King James Version, I'm sorry to say. You know, and it's not because it's, you know, it's still the Bible. You know, it's still a book that was written thousands of years ago by people who didn't really understand the world as much as we do now. You know? And that's really the point I wanted to make with this gigantic question of which version of the Bible is the best. Who knows? And why does it matter so much?